Hello and welcome to yet another tutorial by Davies Media Design. My name is Michael Davies and today I'm going to be showing you how to open raw images using GIMP 2.10. This is the stable release version of GIMP. It's the first stable release version in 6 years, so I'm really excited. And this is the first tutorial we've done with the stable release version, as this just came out a couple days ago. I've done a few tutorials with GIMP 2.10 release candidate 1 and 2, and you could still check those out if you're using GIMP 2.10 because the features are essentially the same. The main difference now is that the bug fixes have been worked out. Anyways, one of the features of GIMP 2.10 is that it supposedly integrates with RAW photos, so you should be able to open RAW photos into GIMP now, and I'm going to show you how to do that today. But before we get into that, I just want to direct you guys over to my website at daviesmediadesign.com/tutorials. As always, we've got plenty of video and text tutorials on here, so definitely check those out. You can also enroll in our GIMP photo editing course on Udemy, from beginner to pro photo retoucher, and we're officially over 200 students, so thank you to everybody that's enrolled. And you can support us on Patreon to help our channel grow and get some cool rewards in return. And I'll include a link to our Patreon page as well as a link to our Udemy course in the description, along with any other links that are relevant to this tutorial. So there are two RAW editors that are associated with GIMP, and you guys might have heard of these. There's Darktable and there's RAWTherapee. There's other free RAW editors out there, but these two are kind of the consensus ones that work well with GIMP and also just work well in general. And so the GIMP development team has worked to integrate these two programs with GIMP. So basically what you need to do is download one of these programs. I'm going to recommend downloading Darktable, and the reason for this is because I mentioned that these programs are supposed to seamlessly integrate with the new GIMP 2.10, but unfortunately I haven't had luck with RAWTherapee, and based on what I've read, RAWTherapee does have problems working with Windows. If you're using a Linux computer, it should work fine, at least from what I've read. I don't use Linux, so I haven't tried it out myself. But RAWTherapee is a great RAW editor, and I am going to show you how you can still open RAW images in GIMP using RAWTherapee on a Windows computer, but we're going to save that for after. So go ahead and click install right here, and that's going to take you to the install page, and it's going to ask you to choose your operating system. So you've got all the various operating systems on here. I went ahead and clicked on the Windows because I'm using a Windows. There's also the Mac OS here. So click here to download the latest Windows installer for Darktable. And this executable file is going to download. Go ahead and click on this once this is finished downloading and go through the steps, the installation steps. It's pretty easy. And that'll install Darktable on your computer. Now, once Darktable is installed, go ahead and close down GIMP and then open it back up. And I love how fast GIMP 2.10 opens, by the way. And now what you need to do is go to File, Open, and locate your RAW file in the Open Image dialog box. And go ahead and click open once you have your RAW file selected. Usually it's an ARW file type. All right, so now we have our image open in Darktable here, and I'll freeze frame it on that message that popped up when we first opened this, but it said that closing Darktable will allow GIMP to load it. And so that's the key to remember. And we can come over here and make some edits. So I'm clicked on this option right here. I'm not going to get too much into editing in Darktable, but we can adjust the contrast, brightness, and saturation here. So I can turn the contrast up a little bit, the brightness up a little bit, the saturation. I did this a little earlier, so it looks like it saved my settings from earlier. And same with the shadows and highlights. I can just decrease the shadows a little bit and increase the highlights a little bit. And then I can also come over to exposure if I want, and just increase the exposure slightly. So I'll just leave the settings at that for now for the sake of time. But all I have to do to open this image into GIMP is come over here and just close Darktable out. And you'll see after I close that this loading bar will start to load the image. And now our RAW image file is open into GIMP. All right, so that's Darktable. RAWTherapee is a little different. When I tried to do this same technique with RAWTherapee, just going to File, Open, and choosing a RAW file, RAWTherapee actually didn't work. So it looks like RAWTherapee doesn't quite work with Windows yet. Although, again, based on what I've read in the forums and everything, it appears that RAWTherapee does work for Linux versions, and I'm not sure for Mac OS X. I haven't heard anything about that. But if you do want to use RAWTherapee, let's just say for whatever reason you prefer it, what you do is you go to RAWTherapee, just go ahead and open that up on your computer. All right, once you open RAWTherapee, come over here to your preferences. And that was in the bottom left corner there. All right, so inside your general preferences, come down here to external editor, and you'll see you have three options, and one of them is actually the GIMP installation directory, but I haven't had any luck getting this to work properly. So just come down here to the custom command line, and type in manually exactly how you see here if you're using GIMP 2.10. And I'll actually just copy this and paste it in the description of the video so you guys can copy it. So once you have that set up, press OK. And now you can come over to your RAW file and just right click on it and go to Open With. And if you don't see RAWTherapee here, just go to Choose Another App. And then you'll see RAWTherapee here, or you might have to scroll through these. And you may even need to click More Apps, but just find RAWTherapee and click OK. And so that will open our image into RAWTherapee. And again, you can make some adjustments here. Just for the sake of time, I'm not going to do any of the adjustments right now. But then you can come over here and there's a little icon that says Edit Current Image in External Editor. And if you have it set up correctly, when you click on this, it should open it up into GIMP. Right now you guys can't see it, but my little GIMP icon here on my taskbar is flashing orange. So you'll see it here. And it's going to ask you to convert to the native sRGB found in GIMP. So just go ahead and hit Convert. And that will bring in your raw image into GIMP. So just a little recap, Darktable does work a little bit more seamlessly at the time of this tutorial. And that allows you to just go to File, Open, and open those raw images directly into GIMP. But you can still open images from RAWTherapee. It just takes a couple extra steps to set it up. Now, for those of you saying that Photoshop opens up raw images directly in Photoshop and it doesn't require an external app, that's actually not the case. Photoshop does use something called Camera Raw, and they've just managed to build Camera Raw, which is an external app, directly into Photoshop. So you're not actually opening it into Photoshop when you're opening raw files in Photoshop. You're opening it up into Camera Raw, and then Camera Raw then exports that image into Photoshop. But it is a little bit more seamless right now because Photoshop did build Camera Raw directly into Photoshop, whereas you do have to just download Darktable first before you can open things up into GIMP. But once you download Darktable, you can essentially open up raw images easily into GIMP the same way you can do in Photoshop. All right, so that's it for this tutorial. If you enjoyed it, please subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/DaviesMediaDesign. We're gonna be putting up more GIMP 2.10 tutorials in the coming days, so check those out. You can also visit our website at daviesmediadesign.com/tutorials, and you can enroll in our GIMP photo editing course from beginner to pro photo retoucher on Udemy. And I'll include a link to that as well as a link to our Patreon page and all of the relevant links from this tutorial in the description of the video. So thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.